Hey everyone, Mark here. This is part two of my lemons with black background oil painting. Worked on the black background, underpainted that. Now I'm going to start painting the lemons. And for that, I'm just going to use CAD yellow with some white. So I'll just start off with some CAD yellow. Could use lemon yellow for this also if you want. I just happen to have CAD yellow with me. Take a little white with it to kind of calm it down a little bit. And I'll use a flat brush and I'll kind of go into this area where this opening is for this lemon. Start to fill that in. Actually, I'll draw where this area is, where it's yellow here. I'm working outdoors here, so there's a lot of birds in the background making noise. Sorry for that. So I'm just filling in this area here. This is the fruit of the lemon. You can see where it's cut. Kind of work inside out, outside in. Figure out how big I want this area to be. I'll pull it this way a little bit more here. Should be nice and round. So I have that filled in. Now I need to fill in this area here. Yellow. He's a little bit more of a straight yellow with less white into it. A little bit of a stronger color. Get that filled in. It was starting to look like the opening here. There's where it goes back. Now, I need to fill in this lemon here. White and yellow. Get that all filled in. Hand out of the way as much as possible. I need to be a little bigger on this side here. This goes back, should be highest right here. That. make that as smooth as possible. The edge. You can see how it's starting to come to life though a little bit. It's a nice contrast between the black background and the yellow lemon. That's what makes it look nice. Try not to touch the black too much, because it is a little bit still wet. So just pull it around there. They'll turn green if they touch each other. So try not to touch there. A little bit's alright. I'll just go over it later. So that's filled in pretty well. Just a little better shape here. So I'm going to wash the brush, and actually I'm going to wash the brush, clean, just use straight white. I'm going to paint in this rind area with just white. Just white for that. Brush clean. Not any green on it or anything. Straight white. Fill in this area. Titanium white I'm using. I usually use titanium white. I use zinc white or flake white. Go on there. So I'm gonna get that filled in. These lines covered too that I put in here when I drew it. Right there. Alright, so that gives us some of the rind. I'll sort of pull it in there a little bit with the spokes of a wheel. So get the feel of the lemon. Push some of that white off, back into the yellow, kind of go around it here with the yellow. Make it look like the outer edge there. It should go straight. Let's see. It should go straight there. And the yellow there. Okay, so that's starting to come together. Now I'm going to make some shadow color. Now on the color wheel, the opposite of yellow is purple. So to make a nice shadow color, I'm going to mix yellow with purple. So I'm going to take some little crimson and blue mixed. First I'm going to mix crimson with blue. Make purple and then mix it with the yellow, and that'll be my shadow. So I gotta turn this purple first. Turn that purple. And that's opposite of yellow in the color wheel. If you look at a color wheel, you can see the opposite colors. When you mix colors on the color wheel that are opposite of each other, then you can turn them into like a grayish color. See that? And that could be a good color for shadow. Mixed in there pretty good. That makes a nice shadow color, as opposed to just putting black and having it turn green. See, that doesn't turn green because it's purple and yellow. All right, so I'm gonna think about where my shadows are. There's a shadow right under here. One shadow there, there's a shadow, let's see, under here. So that comes there, goes back a little bit, and that's way under there. Start to establish that. Establish that shadow, I'm leaving a little bit of yellow on the bottom there. Blend it, wash that brush. Let me get myself a blender brush at some point. Get that brush sort of clean. And where it comes together, just sort of pull it together a little bit. Sort of bring it together. Doesn't have to be over blended, just kind of bring it together a little. You can blend from the light into the dark. That's gonna come together in there. Put a little bit of that yellow in there. Use your finger too if you want to. Sometimes your finger is a better blender than the brush. So that blends it in. whatever reason, the brush didn't blend too well today, so I'm going to use my finger to blend. Alright, so that gives me a little bit better of a blend. Watch that brush again. Another paper towels there. Use a different brush, and I'm just going to kind of tap where the highlights are on the lemon. Start to establish that a little bit. A couple highlights over here. And here around the middle part here where the inside is. Pull that in there. Make sure it's exactly in the center here. I got it a little bit off. Should be more a little lower right there. And little highlights on here. Just use a straight white. It's like the spokes of a wheel. So breaking up some of these lines. That's all there is to it. Alright, so that's the underpainting of my lemons black background oil painting. Hope you guys enjoyed that, and I'll be back next time and start overpainting. Put another layer for the black background on, put a little medium in there, make it shiny, and start working on the lemons again. And then there's some reflections on the table, which is going to be kind of fun to paint, and we'll go from there. So happy Monday, everybody, and thanks for watching.